Shalom, shalom, and welcome back to another episode of Messianic Moments. This week's Torah portion, Toldot, which means generations, is a portion that's packed with drama, destiny, and deep spiritual lessons. So let's uncover some of its treasures together. Toldot begins in Genesis chapter 25, verse 19, and it takes us through the lives of Yitzchak, or Isaac, and Rivka, Rebecca, and more specifically, their twin sons, Esau, or Esau, and Yaakov, Jacob. Now, from the very beginning, their story is intense. Even in the womb, these brothers are wrestling. When Rivka sees God, she's told in Genesis chapter 25, verse 23, two nations are in your womb, and two peoples will be separated from your body. One people will be stronger than the other, and the older will serve the younger. Now, this prophecy sets the stage for the events to follow. Jacob, Yaakov, buying Esau's birthright for a bowl of stew, Isaac's blessing being secured through Rivka's guidance, and the sibling rivalry that shapes the destinies of nations. But let's pause and look a little deeper. What's really going on here? In rabbinic Judaism, it sees Jacob and Esau as more than just two brothers. They're symbols of two opposing forces, the spiritual and the material. The sages often compare Yaakov to the tent-dwelling scholar devoted to Torah, while Esau represents physical might and worldly pursuits. Yet Esau isn't merely a villain. The rabbinic commentary reminds us that Esau's descendants also have a role in God's plan. Rabbi Hirsch teaches that Esau's strength was meant to complement Jacob's spirituality, working together to bring God's light into the world. The tragedy is that Esau squandered this potential. In Messianic Judaism, we recognize these themes, but take them even further. Yaakov and Esau reflect the tension that we all face as believers, the pull between the spiritual calling that we have and also our earthly, physical, fleshly desires. Paul captures this beautifully in Romans chapter 7 when he describes the struggle between the flesh and the spirit. And here's the messianic twist. Yeshua, our Messiah, embodies the perfect balance. He lived in the world but wasn't of the world, right? He lived in the world but wasn't of the world. He shows us how to navigate the tension that Jacob and Esau represent by aligning our lives with God's purposes. And I believe that one of the best illustrations of this is when Yeshua sat upon the untamed colt, which then took him into the city. Right? And that untamed colt symbolically represents the flesh. It symbolically represents the Esau, the animal that's within us, that desires the world, that desires the flesh. It's untamed. And Yeshua, representing of Yaakov, Jacob, sits upon the colt. He doesn't get rid of the colt. The colt doesn't go away forever. It's not completely destroyed, but it is subdued. It's subdued. And when you sit upon that colt and subdue it to do the will of the Lord, that is what is working together. And that's what this message is talking about. Now, moreover, the prophecy about the older serving the younger points us to Yeshua's redemptive role. Just as Yaakov, Jacob, the younger son, secured the blessing for his family, Yeshua, as the second Adam, secures the ultimate blessing of restoration for all of humanity. So what does this all mean for us today? How can the story of Jacob and Esau inspire us to grow in our faith? Here's a takeaway that I think for all of us we can use. Let's embrace our spiritual inheritance. Just like Yaakov valued the birthright, we're called to value the spiritual blessings we've been given through Messiah. This means prioritizing time with God, digging into Scripture, meditating on the Word day and night, and living with eternity in mind. At the same time, let's not neglect the Esau that is in us, the practical side of life, our jobs, families, education, daily responsibilities. Who's going to clean the dishes tonight? They're all responsibilities and opportunities to serve God. The challenge is to make sure that our spiritual identity directs our earthly actions and not the other way around. We need to direct the untamed colt that we sit upon, not let the colt buck us off or take us on a path that we're not supposed to be going down. We are in control. We have dominion in Yeshua's authority over the colt that we sit upon. Maybe this week, take some time to reflect. Are you more focused on the stew that's in front of you? You know, the temporary comforts of life? Or on the eternal birthright that God has given you? Ask him to help you align your priorities with his. Parashat Toldot reminds us that our choices shape our destinies. Like Yaakov and Esau, we're part of a greater story, one that began with Avraham, Abraham, Isaac, and then Jacob, and finds its fulfillment in Yeshua, the Messiah. So let's live in a way that honors that story, carrying the light of Torah and the truth of Messiah into the world. Thanks for joining me on this journey through Parashat Toldot and for yet another Messianic moment. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to subscribe, share it with a friend or two. Make sure to leave a review as well. You can find more on wherever you listen to podcasts, more episodes. Until next time, may your week be filled with shalom and the richness of God's blessings in Yeshua's name. Shalom, shalom.